स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्द्रवः त्रायन्तां वो मदृतोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छतो नखाः. लास्ट क्लास वी लुक्ड एट हाउ गुणास एंड अलंकारास वेरी डिफरेंट एंड हाउ द गुणास आर प्लेस्ड विद रेस्पेक्ट टू रसम. नाउ वी विल लुक एट दोष प्रसंगात. सो व्हेन ही सेड सः प्रसादः गुणः ज्ञेयः सर्वरस साधारण क्रियः इन दैट वृत्ति ही आल्सो सेड सच अ सर्वरस साधारणः गुणः सर्वरचना साधारणश्च व्यंग्यार्थापेक्षया एव मुख्यतया व्यवस्थितः मन्तव्यः. दैट सर्वरस साधारणः अपि दैट अर्थं प्रसादं इज बेस्ड ऑन द व्यंग्यार्थ और it is prasada guna is in support of the rasam and not the vachyartham. It is more to do with the vyangyartha. So in connection with that, he wants to point out that some of the doshas that have been pointed by Bhamaha etc are only they are only anitya dosha and nityatvam anityatva means where you have read in Kavya Prakasham also, you will be reading it in the seventh Ullasam, or we've read it, I think. So Shruti Dushtadayaha Doshaha Anityaha Yecha Darshitaha Dhvanyatmanyeva Shringareteheyaha Iti Udahritaha. Shruti Dushtaha Artha Dushtaha Kalpana Dushtaha and Shruti Kashtatva. These are the four doshas that Bhamaha has pointed out as Vacham Doshaha, which is vachyarthasya or shabdasya cha doshaha. So shruti dushta artha dushte cha kalpana dushtam ityapi shruti kashtam tathaiva ahu vacham dosham chaturvidham. So these are the four types of doshas that Vamaha has said. That's what he means by when he says shruti dushta adayaha adipadena artha dosha kalpana dushtam kalpana doshaha and shruti kashtatva. These are all doshas. These are called anitya dosha because only in certain places it is anitya dosham. It is not considered as dosham everywhere. Mainly where shringara is an angi. If the shringara rasa is the angi and it is the dhvani atma bhutam, आत्मभूतः शृङ्गाररसः यत्र प्रतिपाद्यते तत्रैव एते चत्वारः दोषाः न सर्वत्र. सो वाट् आर् द प्लेसेस् वेर् इट् नीड् नाट् बी न त्याज्याः मीन्स् दे नीड् ने न हेयाः ध्वन्यात्मनि एव शृङ्गारे ते हेयाः. Anyatra tu, what is that anyatra, where they can be used, where these doshas, even if they are used, are not called dosha. They need not be dosha. In fact, they can be gunam or kvachit na gunaha na pi doshaha. We've been seeing in Kavya Prakasham 7th Ullasa, you will find that it is there in the Doshanam Adoshatvam section. After he finishes all Artha Dosha and just before going to Rasa Doshas, he talks about what are the sthalams where the doshas can become either a gunam. It need not be considered as dosha also. So neither it is a guna nor a dosha. So there can be several steps. Since this is just an analysis text, he is not going into details or enlisting all of those things. For that, we need to look at Kavya Prakasham. So, anityaha doshaha cha, this vritti is a vivaranam of the karika. Anityaha doshaha cha, ye shruti dushtadayaha suchitaha. Suchitaha means bamahena suchitaha. Shruti dushtadayaha. Te api, vachye arthe na, व्यंग्ये श्रृंगार व्यतिरेकिणी व्यंग्ये न श्रृंगार व्यतिरेकिणी व्यंग्ये न श्रृंगारे ध्वनेहे अनात्मभूते न ध्वनेहे अनात्मभूते श्रृंगारे अपि न हेयाः इत्यन्वयः. Okay, so that heya padam, you'll have to use it for everything. Heyaha means tyajyaha, parityajyaha. What does it mean now? Arthamatre vachye. When the purport of a shlokam, when the main when the important thing is just the vachyartham that we are talking about. If it's a normal shloka where there is no great dhvani or where the vyangyartham is not as important as bhangi rupena yatra vachyartaha pradhanataya avabhasate, tatra shruti dushtadeha doshaha natyajyaha, you can actually use it and tesham doshatvam navidyate tatra. At least some sort of a chamatkaram can be there, no? If you are not, see, Chitrakavyams and all have their purpose is to highlight that Chitrabandha, that Murajabandha, and all those types of different Shabdalankaras. So if your focus is only that Vachyartham and you want to show your prowess in it, I always like to give the example of Paduka Sahasram, where he has given all varieties. You can have Atyanta Tiraskrita Vachyadvani, you will have Avivakshita Vachyadvani, you will have Asamlakshikramadvani, Bhavadvani is there. So many things are there. In all that, he also has something called a Chitrapaddhati, where he has given focus for Shabdalankara and Bandha, all the different types of Chakrabandha, Murajabandha, Padmabandha, etc., etc. So if, in those places, it is the Vachyartham that is much more important, and the Vachaka Shabda, which is more important, there, these need not be considered as dosham. It can actually highlight what the poet wishes to convey through his shlokas. He actually wants to show his capability of creating such shlokas also. So, Vachye Arthamatre, Vachye, Vachyartaha eva yatra pradhanataya bhasate, tatra ete natyajyaha, adava na dushtaha. Next is, Vyangye Shringara Vyatirekini, if the Shringara Virodhirasam, Bibatsam, if that is the Vyangya, Vyangyartha, or if there is a Shantarasa, that is Vyangyartha, and you want to, then Shruti Dushtam can be included in the Artham or in the words, either the Shabdas or the words can have Shruti Dushta, where it will highlight the Shringara Virodhirasa, which is being highlighted as the Vyangyartha. Which is the Vengartham and which is the Dvani Atma Bhutam. So, he is only talking about the status of doshas as far as Shringara Rasam is concerned. So, Vyangye Shringara Vyatirekini Te Abhi Na Na Tyajyaha Adava Na Dushtaha. Next, Shringare Dvanehe Anatma Bhute Sati. When Shringara is like a Rasavadalankaram and the Pradhanam is something else. Anya rasaha, shringara atiriktaha rasaha, yatra angitaya bhasante, tatra api, you can use these things. Shruti dushtam is fine. Artha dushtam is fine. So, shringareva dhvanehe anatma bhute kintarhi. So, where can these actually be doshas? Where should it be avoided at all costs? So, dhvanyatmani eva shringare angitaya vyangye teheyaha iti udakhritaha. Okay. So, where shringara, dhvanyatmani eva shringare angitaya. Angitaya vyangye, vyangye sati, where dhvani, it is like an atma. Dvanyatma means dvani kavye, atmataya, shringare, bhasamane, sati. Angitaya, when it is the vyangyartha, when shringara is the suggested and it has more importance in the dvani kavya, in that, te heyaha, you have to avoid these doshas at all costs. Iti udakhritaha, anyatha, anyatha hi tesham anitya doshata eva nasyat. Then we can't call those as anitya dosha. Nitya dosham, anitya dosham means, see, nitya dosham is something like vyakaranam. You can't have vyakarana asuddhatvam in any kavyam. You cannot have, see, those are all basic issues. Without, if that is not, if you do not adhere to the grammatical rules, then it is a problem. It is a nitya dosham there. Rasa dosham. You are trying to portray Shringara rasam, but all you are saying is only bibatsam. If the way you are describing is only bibatsam for a sahrudaya, then that is a nitya dosham. So you'll have to be very careful about nityatvam and anityatvam. Doshas can be it has to be avoided at, in all cases, whether it is Vivatsa rasam or Shringara rasam. There are some which have to be definitely avoided, like meter or Vyakaranam. These are all Nitya doshas. There are other things also in the Dosha Prakaranam you will read in Kavya Prakasham. So Anitya doshas are Shruti Drushtadayaha Anityaha Iti Uktaha. So Anityatvam means it is not eternal. So in certain cases it is a dosham, in certain cases it is not a dosham, or it can be actually a gunam. Like Shruti Dushtatvam or Shruti Katu. Shruti Katu is a dosha in Shringaram or Vipralamba or Karuna, but it is not in a Raudra Rasa Sthala or in a Bivatsa Rasa Sthala. So Tesham Anitya Doshata Eva Nasyat, we cannot even consider it as an Anityam if such rules do not exist. If I do not confine it as a dosham only in certain cases, then there is no, I can't call it as Anityam. Evam ayam asam lakshyakramadyotaha dvanehe atma pradarshitaha samanyena. Samanyena means in a general aspect we have shown that what is asam lakshyakramavyangyam. So let's go back to just one step and understand dvani has two varieties, avivakshita vachyadvani and vivakshita anyaparavachyadvani. Vivakshita anyaparavachyadvani is avivakshita vachyadvani is atyanta tiraskritam and arthanantara sankramitam. Vivakshita anyaparavachyadvani he divided into two, asamlakshikramadhvani and samlakshikramadhvani. In that, when we looked at asamlakshikramadhvani, it is rasa bhava tadabhasa bhava shanti bhava shabalata, all of these are there. So in that context he said gunam actually should be rasa akshittam. So he started talking about guna and its placement. Now doshas also, in certain rasas it is gunam and in certain rasas it is not gunam. So this it is just in a general manner he has said what is asamlakshikramadhvani. Now if we have to go to its varieties, prabedham, prabedasya anantyam darshayati adhuna. So what are the different bheda, prabeda? Alakshikrama vyangya, we have just said that it is rasadvani, etc., etc. It's actually only one, because if you have to consider the different varieties of asamlakshikrama vyangyam, it is going to be infinite. Tasya anganam prabedaha ye prabedaha swagatascheye tesham anantyam anyonya sambandha parikalpane. So angitaya, it's just an explanation of what is there. So tasya anganam prabedaha, tasya ityukte rasasya rasadehe. What is that rasam? Angitaya vyangyaha rasadihi vivakshita anyaparavachyasya dhvanehe ekaha atma yaha uktaha tasya ityartha. So what is that tasya? Rasadehe. It rasadehe prabedhaha. That's what we are going to look at. What is that rasam? Angitaya. It is pradhanataya. It is that important vyangya, that which is suggested. If the rasa which is suggested and it is important, and that which is called as the Atma, Ekaha Atma, it is the only Atma of Vivakshita Anyaparavachyadvani. Vivakshita Anyaparavachyadvani can have two varieties, Asamlakshikrama and Samlakshikrama. Samlakshikrama is you go through a process and then you have Rasapratiti, whereas Asamlakshikrama is just immediate and quick. There is no interval between the understanding the Vachyartham and getting the Rasapratiti. So vivakshita annaparavachya dvanehe ekaha atma yaha uktaha tadrishaha rasadehe anganam. What does anganam mean? From the shloka he explains it. Vachya vachaka anupatinam alankaranam. Vachya vachaka anupati means karanam. Vachya vachakanam karana rupataya ye alankaraha vidyante. So vachya vachaka anupatinam alankaranam. So you can have, if let's say there is Shringara rasam and then you can have vachyalankara there, vachaka, which is shabdalankara. So either the artham can give rise to a beauty or the shabdam can give rise to a beauty. So vachyavachakanam anupatinam alankaranam, those which help the vachyartha and the vachakartha are the different types of shabdalankara and arthalankara. So this is one variety. Ye pravedaha niravadhayaha, there is no limit to the different varieties of the alankaras that can exist within that rasam. So if you have a Shringara Rasam Pradhana Shlokam, there can be many varieties based on, okay, this is through Yamakam or this is through Upama, I get this Shringara Rasam. This is through Utpreksha. There are different varieties of Utpreksha also. Next, there is whole other varieties of Rupakam also. From this Rupakam, we are getting this Rasadvani. So, including all those Angas also, that Rasadvani can be, Asamlakshikrama Rasadvani can be innumerable. So, Niravadhayaha. Next is Swagata Prabedaha, right? Swagatascha. Anganam Prabedaha, first one. Next is Swagataha Prabedaha. So, Swagataha means Tasya Anginaha Arthasya Rasa Bhava Tadabhasa Tat Prashama Lakshanaha. So, you can have Rasadvani, Bhavadvani, Rasabhasadvani, Bhavabhasadvani, and each rasa can be Shringara, Hasya, Karuna, Veera. You can list out all those. And then Bhavadvani means you can have the 8 or 9 Sthayi Bhavas, including 33 Vibhichari Bhavas. Any of those can be a dvani, can be suggested. So that is also Anantyam here. Further divisions are Vibhava, Anubhava, Vyabhichari, Pratipadana Sahita, Anantaha. So, depends on which Vibhavam is used. Vibhavam is, you have two varieties, which is Alambana Vibhava and Uddipana Vibhava. Alambana Vibhavam is from where the rasa, who is the character who induces that rasa in the other person. That is Alambanam, from which, who is the support for that rasam. Uddipanam is the surrounding. So, based on each surrounding, we can have a different variety. If I have to include each one as a different variety, then imagine the number of varieties that I have to count here. So, Vibhava, Anubhava, Vyabhichari Bhava, Pratipadana Sahitaha, those which are being highlighted based on or with the help of Vibhava, Anubhava and Vyabhichari Bhava, Anantaha, they are also innumerable. Swashraya apekshaya nisimanaha. This swashrayam means that alambana vibhava. He is actually talking about the alambana vibhava, which is the nayaka and nayika bhedena, prabhedena. Nayika prabhedastu anantaha. So you can have 8 different types of nayikas, ashtanayika, or you can have uttama madhyama adhama. In a nayaka, you can have daiva nayaka, manusha nayaka, daiva adaiva. You can have a mix of those. These are the different. Swashrayam is alambana vibhavam. Swashraya apekshaya, with respect to the alambana from which the rasa comes out, that is also nissimanaha, it is boundless. Visheshaha tesham anyonya sambandha parikalpane. Next, if we have to mix those two, we can't count beyond that then, right? Kasyachit akriyamane sati, kasyachit anyatamasyapi rasasya prakaraha parisankhyatum na shakyante kimuto sarvesham. Ekasya parasi, anyatamasya means among those 9 rasas, if we just consider one rasa and try to give the different varieties based on what he has given now, alankara, swagata prabheda, swashraya prabheda, iti anganam prabhedaha, iti trividha prabheda yojanena, how is it possible? It is very difficult to count. Parisankhyatum nashakyate kimuta sarvesham. Now, if we have to consider all 9 rasas, what do we do? He takes just one example of Shringara and gives us. Tatahi, Shringarasya anginaha tavat adyau dvau vedau. Shringara rasa can be divided into 2. Sambhoga Shringara and Vipralambha Shringara. Sambhogam is love in union and Vipralambha is love in separation. Sambhogasya cha paraspara prema darshana surata viharanadi lakshanaha prakaraha. अन्योन्य परस्पर प्रेम दर्शन प्रेम दर्शन द्वे दे सी ईच अदर शोइंग देयर लव टू ईच अदर दिस कैन बी इन मेनी वेराइटीज नेक्स्ट इज सुरत सुरत इज यूनियन द सेक्शुअल अट्रैक्शन द इंट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द नायक एंड द नायिका इफ यू टेक कामशास्त्रम I think he is mentioned in the one of the Vyakhyanams called Divyanjanam that there are the, in the second Adhikaranam there are different types of Alingaram that have been said. Eight different types of Alingana, several types of Chumbanam, several types of Nakachedam. So if you take each and every variety that is mentioned in the Kama Shastra, it's going to be Anantam. Lakshanaha Viharanam means where what is that Uddipana Vibhavam. Are the Nayika and the Nayika near a lake? Or are they under the moonlight? Or are they in the Pramadavanam? Depending on the Deshakaladi, Ashraya Bedena. So there can be differences. So Lakshanaha, Prakaraha, Vipralambasya cha. First, Vipralambha has a main four divisions. Abhilasha, Irshya, Viraha and Pravasa. These are the four types of divisions is the main one. There can be other things also. So he says, Abhilasha, Irshya, Viraha, Pravasa, Viprambhadayaha. In Lochanam, he gives a definition for all these four types. Abhilasha, Vipralambaha, Dvayoho, Anyonya, Jeevita, Sarvasva, Abhimanatmikayam, Ratau, Utpannayam, Api. Even though the Nayaka and the Nayika feel that they cannot live without each other, Jeevita, Sarvasvam, He is my life and she is my life. That is the idea that they have. And that is the relationship Rati, even though there is such a Rati in between them, Kutaschita Hetoho, because of some reason, Aprapta Samagamatve, when they both could not get together. That is called Apilasha Vipralambaha. They both like each other. They both are very much involved with each other, but they're not able to come together. That is Abhilasha Vipralambaha. Irshya Vipralambaha. Pranaya Khandanadina Khanditaya Saha. Khandita Naika is Parshwameti Priyo Yasyaha Anyasamboga Chinnitaha Sa Khandita Katita Dhirehi Irshya Kashayita. Sa Khanditeti Katita Dhirehi Irshya Kashayita. This is the definition given, I think, in Sahitya Darpanam. I'm not sure. So Khandita Nayika is a person when the Nayaka comes near her and he has the chinham of Anya Nayika Samboga. So Anya Samboga Chinnitaha Ekaha Nayakaha Yada Nayikayaha Samipam Agachati Tada she becomes very jealous. That is, and she separates herself from him. She does not want to be with him. And her jealousy is much more than the love that she wants to show him. Or she does not want to be with him at that point because she is extremely jealous. So that is called Irshya Vipralambaha, the separation due to Irshya. The definitions and examples are all in Kavya Prakasham 4th Ullasa. Next is Viraha Vipralambha. Viraham Punaha Khanditaya Prasadhyamanaya Api Prasadam Anugrannantya Tataha Paschattapa Paritattvena Virahot Khanditaya Saha. The scene is, imagine she is angry. Prasadhyamanaya Api, the Nayaka tries to placate her. Prasadam Anugrannantya Agrannantya, she is not accepting his the peace pigeon. She does not want to accept his efforts to bring her anger down. Tataha then he goes away. So after that what happens is she regrets. So paschattapa paritattvena then she is because of that viraha she is utkanthita. Is very dukkhita. So dukkhita sa, that is viraha vipralambaha. So any shlokam which describes a woman who is regretting this separation is viraha vipralamba shloka. Next is pravasa vipralambam, where it is proshita bhartrika, whose husband is gone away on journey and she is left alone. ఆదిగ్రహణాత్ శాపకృత విచ్ ఇస్ యువర్ మేఘ సందేశం బికాస్ ఆఫ్ అ శాపం ది యక్ష ఇస్ సెపరేటెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది యక్షి అండ్ ది యక్షి ఇస్ అలోన్ సో బోత్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ విప్రలంబ శృంగారం ఈస్ శాప విప్రలంబ శృంగారం సో తేషాం చ ఇన్ దీస్ ఫోర్ టైప్స్ ప్రత్యేకం ఈచ్ వన్ నౌ వాట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యాపన్ తేషాం చ ప్రత్యేకం విభావ అనుభావ వ్యభిచారి భేదాః ఇట్ కెన్ బి సెపరేటెడ్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ విభావ అనుభావ వ్యభిచారి భావ తేషాం చ దేశకాలాది ఆశ్రయ అవస్థా భేదః దేశ భేదః అవస్థా కాల భేదః ఆశ్రయ భేదః అవస్థా భేదః హూ ఇస్ ద పర్సన్ హూ ఇస్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సింగ్ దిస్ రసం స్వగత భేద అపేక్షయ ఏకస్య తస్య స్వగత భేద అపేక్షయ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ద వెరైటీస్ దట్ యూ క్యాన్ హైలైట్ ఏకస్య తస్య ఈవెన్ వన్ రసం క్యాన్ బి అపరిమేయత్వం ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇమ్మెజరబుల్ కెనాట్ మెజర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ వెరైటీస్ దట్ ఆర్ దేర్ కిం పునః అంగ ప్రభేద ప్రకల్పనాయ ఇఫ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు దెన్ ఇఫ్ ద శృంగార రసం ఈస్ అంగ ప్రభేదం మీన్స్ తేహి అంగ ప్రభేదా ప్రత్యేకం అంగి ప్రభేద సంబంధ పరికల్పనే క్రియమాణే సతి ఆనంత్యం అంగ ప్రభేదం మీన్స్ వన్ రస ఈస్ ఎన్ అంగం టు అన్ అదర్ రసం వేర్ దర్ ఇస్ అ రస సంకర ఇన్ దోస్ ప్లేసెస్ ఆల్సో ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు లుక్ ఎట్ ద డిఫరెంట్ వెరైటీస్ ఆనంత్యం ఏవ వి కెనాట్ గివ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఫర్ ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఆఫ్ దోస్ సో వన్ మినిట్ తేహి సారీ దింగ్మాత్రం తు ఉచ్యతే ఈచ్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ వెరైటీస్ కెనాట్ బి ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ అండ్ గివెన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఫర్ దోస్ సో దింగ్మాత్రం తు ఉచ్యతే ఏన వ్యుత్పన్నానాం సతేతసాం బుద్ధిః ఆసాదితాలోకా సర్వత్రైవ భవిష్యతి దింగ్మాత్రం ఉచ్యతే దింగ్మాత్రం మీన్స్ జస్ట్ ఎ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఐఎమ్ ఇండికేటింగ్ only an indication is being given here by which yena vyutpannanam sachetasam those who are capable of imagining the rest sachetasa sachetasanam sahrdayanam vyutpannanam mahakavina so vyutpannanam sahrdayanam athava vyutpannanam mahakavinam buddhihi ఆసాదిత ఆలోక ప్రకాశయుక్తాసత్ సర్వత్రైవ భవిష్యతి సర్వత్ర సర్వరస స్థలేషు అపి తేషాం బుద్ధిః ప్రవర్తతే సో దే ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఇన్ అదర్ కేసెస్ ఆల్సో వి ఆర్ జస్ట్ షోయింగ్ ఇన్ సర్టన్ కేసెస్ నౌ హీ షోడ్ హౌ చంచద్భుజ భ్రమిత ఆల్ దోస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ అండ్ ది ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ దట్ హీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో జస్ట్ ఇన్ ఇండికేషన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ If you say just Shringaram, Shringara can appear only in this case, with this desham, with this kalam, you cannot specify it. It depends on the Sahridaya and the Mahakavi, the creativity. Mahakavinam pratibha visheshena yatkamapi chamatkaram uttabhitum shaknoti. Dingmatra kathanenahi vyutpannanam sahridayanam ekatrapi rasabhede saha alankaraihi in just one rasa in just one variety of rasam the sahrdayas can understand alankaraihi saha along with the rasas the anga angi bhava parijnanat when he knows the vyutpanna is not just a person who knows vocabulary who has the sanskrit vocabulary in hand it also means angangi bhava parijnanam that is very important where the what is the angi rasam what is angi first of all what is pradhanam and how to put that pradhan rasam as the angi kadam upayoktavyam and what all should be the angas of that particular rasa that jnanam should be there parijnanam paritaha jnana vishay in its entirety he should have that knowledge in his mind only then asadita aloka buddhih he gets that prakasha prapta alokam means alokaha prakashah Which means the buddhi has that understanding jnana sarvatraiva bhavishyati and he can understand it in every case you don't need to give a case for everything with one he can apply it to other similar cases also now in shringaram what is the placement of shabdalankaras the next two karikas next two, three karikas, and a conclusion is given about what is the placement of Shabdalankara with respect to Shringara. Shringarasya tatra, tatra means in the as we are, because we he the first thing he said was Anganam, where is that karika? Tasya Anganam Prabedaha, Tasya Rasadehe, Anganam Prabedaha, Chukti Prathamam, we look at Shabdalankara. So what is the position of that Shabdalankara? Shritatra, Shringarasya Anginaha, Yatna, the Egarupanu Bandhavane, Sarveshweva Prabedeshu, Nanuprasaha, Prakashakaha. Angi, Shringara is the Angirasam, it is the Pradhanam. Whatever prabedam that we have said for Shringara, teshu sarveshu api eka prakara anubandhitaya, eka rupa anubandhavan, eka rupam, in all the different varieties of Shringara that we have tried to say, there is one common thing called that love sentiment, right? And when we are writing a shlokam, there should not be too much of ups and downs. You have to maintain that rasa, and when you want to portray that pratipadya vishayam, if it is the same, you can try to use anuprasa, but that anuprasa can never become a vyanjakam. What is this anuprasam? Shabda samyam vaishamye api swarasya. Swarasya vaishamye api shabda samyam yatra athava varna samyam yatra. If the consonants are the same, you have the these are all used, or ta, you have, but tatihi, tirthaha, these are all where the swara is different. That is, the vowels are different, but the letters are repetitive. It's called alliteration. So that is called anuprasam. It is a shabdalankara in Sanskrit. That anuprasa, when in Shringara rasam, it cannot become a vyanjakam, it cannot be a suggestor. It is only the beautifying aspect for the shabdam. It cannot be considered as suggesting the rasam. Through that anuprasa, I am never going to understand Shringaram. I can only understand Shringaram. Vibhava anubhava vibhichari samyogat rasa nishpatihi. That vibhava anubhava vibhichari is important. Okay, so anginaha shungarasya ye prabedaha uktaha teshu sarveshu eka prakara anubandhitaya prabandhena, because the text prabandha has eka prakaram, there is a samana akaram in all the shlokas, then I can just use similar sounding words, right? Pravrittaha anuprasaha, if there is an anuprasa, that can never become the suggestor. It cannot be the vyanjaka. Anginaha ityanena angabhutasya shringarasya ekarupa anubandhi anuprasa nibandhane kamacharam ah. I'm only talking about shringara, which is an angirasam. If it is an angabhutam and something else is angi, say raudram is angi or bhayanakam is angi, something is angi, you don't know, even a bhavam is angi, there ekarupa anubandhi anuprasa, where the anuprasam is, there is a samana akara rupataya yatra bandhaha kriyate anuprasaha nibadhyate tatra kamacharam. Kamacharam means the poet can do ishta vyavaharam, yatecham kuryat anuprasa yukta shloka bandhaha kuryat anuprasa viyukta shloka bandho api kuryat tatasya ishta. Dhvanyatma bhute shungare yamakadi nibandhanam shaktava vipramadittvam vipralambhe visheshataha. Anuprasa is something. See, in all this he is going to say again, rasakshiptataya yasya bandhaha shakyakriyaha bhavet. If it is yatechaya, not yatechaya, yadrichaya, kakataliya nyayena, he will say, you know, if it just falls once in a while, yamakam comes or some shabda alankara is there, it's okay. It na vadakaha tatra, but it is if you use that yamakam, if you want to show your prowess and use yamakam always, that is not going to give me that shringaram. सो ध्वन्यात्मभूते शृङ्गारे यमकादि निबन्धनं शक्तौ अपि ईवन् दो द पोयेट् हेज् द केपबिलिटि आफ् यूसिङ्ग् यमक एक्सेट्रा इन् शृङ्गारं प्रमादित्वम् इट् इस् अ मिस्टेक् प्रमादः मिस्टेक् इट् इस् अ दोष विप्रलम्बे विशेषतः इन् पर्टिक्युलर् वेन् यु आर् ट्रैङ्ग् टु हैलैट् द विप्रलम्ब शृङ्गार रसम् इट् इस् अ फाल्ट् सो ध्वनेः आत्मभूतः शृङ्गारः तात्पर्येण वाच्यवाचकाभ्यां प्रकाश्यमानः करेक्ट् शृङ्गाररसं तात्पर्येण बै यु नो हौ डस् दट् शृङ्गार हौ डु वि गेट् दट् शृङ्गार इस् ओन्लि बै तात्पर्यम् आर् द भक्तुः विवक्षा अथवा कवेः विवक्षा तत्र विद्यते शृङ्गारे शृङ्गाररसः अत्र व्यङ्ग्यभूत व्यङ्ग्यतया प्रतिभासमानः ऐ हाव् टु पुट् दोस् वर्ड्स् लैक् दट् दट् इस् द पोयेट्स् विश् हियर् सो तात्पर्येण वाच्यवाचकाभ्यां प्रकाश्यमानः दट् शृङ्गार आक्चुलि ईस् highlighted only through the vachyartham and vachaka shabdam I accept in such a case also yamakadinam yamaka prakaranam nibandhanam further dushkara shabdabhanga shleshadinam shaktau api shabdadinam nibandhanam you take it as to yamaka prakaranam nibandhanam dushkara shabdabhanga shleshadinam nibandhana okay so yamakaha is described as the definition of yamaka is satyarthe pritagarthayaha sware swara vyanjana samhatehe kramena tenaiva avritti yamakam nigadyate so if a set of consonant and vowels together are repeated in the same manner adana tamasam tamasam nivrittaye I think in Champuramayanam there is a shloka where Valmiki tamasam prapa he reached the tamasa nadi which removes the tamas tamogunam in everybody so the word tamasam and tamasam is repeated twice The meaning is different. Pritagarthayaha, swara vyanjana samhatehe. So there is an artham for both words. There is a repetition. Avrittihi, there is a repetition. In the same manner, kramena, in the same manner it appears the first time. It is repeated in the same manner the second time also. But the meaning is different. Pritak artham, that is yamaka. It can just come once in a while. That's okay. Next is Dushkara, the Yamaka Prakaranam Nibandhanam. The next type of Shabdalankara, he says, is Dushkara Shabda Bhanga or Bhanga Sklesha. So, one is Dushkara Shabda. Dushkara Shabda Bhangaha, I think I made a mistake there. It is not Dushkara Shabda Bhangaha. You take it as Dushkara Shabdaha, which is Muraja, Chakrabandha, Padmabandha, etc. The next is Shabda Bhanga Slesha. Shabda Bhanga Slesham means Bhanga Slesham is Abhanga Slesha and Bhanga Slesha are two types of Slesha Alankara where the words as such they are, they can mean two different meanings. They can give two different meanings. Like in Arjuna can mean Pandavaha, Madhyama Pandavaha, Athava Arjunaha iti Shvetavarnaha. You don't split it at all. Whereas when you say Sarvado Madhavaha, सर्वदः माधवः अथवा सर्वदा उमाधवः इति सर्वदो माधवः शब्दस्य भङ्गः तत्र विद्यते भङ्गेन विभागश्चेत् तत्र श्लेषेण द्वयर्थकः भवति सो इट् बिकम्स् डबल् मीनिङ्ग् बट् यु ब्रेक् द वर्ड् इन् टु टु इन् डिफ्रेण्ट् मेनर् दट् इस् भङ्गश्लेष देर् आल्सो दोस् टैप् आफ् alankaras should not be used in dvanyatma bhute shringare so dvanyatma bhute shring why does he have to say dushkara shabda bhanga shlesha etc because he has said in the karika yamakaadi nibandhanam adi shabdat so yamaka prakaranam nibandhanam athava not athava apicha dushkara bandhanam nibandhanam shabda bhanga shlesha adinam cha shaktau api pramadittvam kavehe shaktir vartate तथापि प्रमादित्वम् एव. प्रमादित्वम् इत्यनेन एतत् दर्श्यते काकतालीयेन कदाचित् कस्यचित् एकस्य यमकादेः निष्पत्तौ अपि. काकतालीयं मीन्स् इन् द तमिळ् काका उकार पनङ्ग पनङ्गा विळुन्दु तिम्बो. When the crow sits on a tala vriksham and it enjoys the tala fruit, that is okay, the palm fruit, then fine. Or if that palm fruit falls down and we are able to enjoy it, that is by chance. That's what it means. So kakatali yena kadachit, somehow kasyachit ekasya yamaka dehe nishpattau api. If one yamaka is present there, it's okay. Bhumna alankarantaravat रसाङ्गत्वेन निबन्धः न कर्तव्यः. भूम्ना मेनि वेरैटीस् लैक् अदर् अलङ्कारास्. इफ् यु टेक् शाकुन्तलम् इन् जस्ट् वन् श्लोकं देर् वुड् बी सम् इट् इस् आक्चुलि शृङ्गारप्रधान श्लोक बट् देर् विल् बी सम् फोर् फैव् अलङ्कारास् विच् यु विल् स्टार्ट् थिङ्किङ्ग् अबौट् ओन्ली लेटर्. The first instant, you will only think of the rasa, rasadvani, but then after that, oh, there is aprasthita prashava, oh, there can be samasokya, oh, there is utpreksha also here. It's only later that there may be so many other alankaras, but you will never identify yamaka or anything there, because it's very important that those should not be employed in shringara. Bhumna, in excess, alankarantaravat, like other arthalankaras, yamaka etc should not be used in excess. Rasangatvena, even if it is only used as a subordinate to the pradhana rasam, nibandaha na kartavyaha, it should not be used. Vipralambe visheshataha ityanena vipralambe saukumarya atishayaha khyapyate. Anena vipralambe karunam saukumarya atishayam. We saw how madhuryam is used, right? Shringare vipralambakye karuneyacha prakarshavat madhuryam ardhradam yati yataha tatra adhikam manaha. Only, see, madhuryam is very important. This yamakam etc. is not important in vipralamba because there is a saukumaryam. There is a softness to that vipralambam more than shringaram. तस्मिन् द्योत्ये विप्रलम्भे द्योत्ये सति यमकादेः अङ्गस्य निबन्धः नियमात् न कर्तव्यः. डेफिनेट्लि यमकः शुड् नाट् बि यूस्ड् इन् विप्रलम्भ. अत्र उक्तिः अभिधीयते. नो, ही सेस् रसाक्षिप्ततया यस्य, दिस् इस् वेरि इम्पोर्टेण्ट् कारिक, रसाक्षिप्ततया यस्य बन्धः शक्यक्रियः भवेत् अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यः. निर्वर्त्यः
निर्वर्त्यः
इर्के निर्वर्त्यः अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यः सः अलङ्कारः ध्वनौ मतः. ध्वनौ स एव अलङ्कारः इति मतः यः अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यः. पृथग्यत्नेन यः निर्वर्तितः सः एव अलङ्कारतया मतः. ध्वनौ ध्वनिविशेषे अथवा असंलक्ष्यक्रमध्वनिविशेषे अलङ्कारः इति कः? अपृथग्यत्न निर्वर्त्यः. इस् वेरि इम्पार्टेण्ट्, मेक् अ नोट् आफ् देट्. सो the poet, if he is able to bring out the rasam without any alankaras also, that's fine. Adena yak kumara haraha sayeva varaha tayeva chaitrakshapaha, in that he will say even without alankara there is a beautiful rasa, that nostalgia that the woman feels when she says yak kumara haraha sayeva varaha, one with whom I had spent so many days before marriage. There was a thrill associated with that, but he is the person whom I have married today. Tayeva chaitrakshapaha, these are those nights that I'm spending with him. It is the same Malaya Marutam and it is the Lata Kunjam where I spent before marriage. Today I am spending it with the same person as my husband, and I am there in that tathapi. Even then sarasaha na asti, she says in the last line adla,
चेतस्समुत्कण्ठते
रेवारोधसि वेतसि तरुतले चेतस्समुत्कण्ठते. I eagerly want to be in that place and that time. It's very important, Deshakala. Today, he is the same husband, all are fine, but that thrill is not there. Where we used to meet secretly without anybody knowing. She's thinking about that olden days in a very nostalgic manner. There is no prakrit, alankaram or anything there. Of course, there are people who will try to bring in visheshokti and vibhavana and all that. The first instant, there are no alankara. But that alankaram also, apritagyatma nirvartyaha, if that alankara has come about, let it be. But that is not my main intention. That's not the kavi's intention. Rasakshiptataya yasya bandha shakyakriyaha bhavet. So nishpattau ascharyabhutaha api. Even though there is an alankara in certain shlokas, where that the rasam is the pradhana, yasya alankarasya, arthalankarasya, maybe shabdalankaranam api, rasakshiptataya eva bandhaha, rasakshiptataya rasabandhaya anukula prayasaha yatra kriyate, rasakshiptataya, rasapradhanataya eva yatra alankaranam bandhaha kriyate shakyakriyaha. If it is possible, saha asmin alakshyakrama vyangye dhvanau, alankaraha iti mataha tasyaiva rasangatvam mukhyam ityarthaha. Actually we'll stop with this. He gives an example for how I'll start again with rasang rasakshiptataya yasya and then go on to the example. So,
So, question, because I don't know many things. So here in that Shrungarasya Anginoho, that we saw that Anuprasa. For that Anuprasa, it is a Shabdalankara, right?
Yes.
Anuprasa. So then with Shabdalankara, is it even possible to bring Vyangyartha?
It is not possible. That's what he is trying to say here. So anuprasaha na prakashakaha.
Na prakashakaha. So because it is shabdalankara. Only with ardhalankara we can bring out that vyanjana vyapara, right? That
yes.
So with shabdalankara, then why is he limiting it only to shringara rasa? It should be for everything, right? Even for any.
So for raudra rasam, if there is anuprasa, it will contribute to it.
Oh.
In Shringara, there is no great contribution because of the Anuprasa or Yamaka.
Even if it is like Mrudu Pada Prayojanam, even then.
Even if there is Mrudu Pada Prayojanam, there is no great contribution towards Shringara Rasam. Whereas in Rautra Rasam, if there is an Anuprasa, it shows the Viratvam or there is the intensity of the anger is shown more. Yes, Anuprasa can contribute in certain manner, but it will not be the Vyanjakatvam. If you look at Ashtapadi, you have Lalita Lavanga Lata Parishilana Komala Malaya Samire. There is so much of Anuprasam in Ashtapadi that Lalitatvam can be there, but it will not be a Vyanjakatvam for Shringara Rasam.
Oh. So will it be a Vyanjakatvam for Raudram or Veeram or... Can it bring out that
Bhuja Bhramita? If you say that Bhuja Bhramita itself brings out the it contributes to it, no? It's a very, very abstract thing. the greatness of Alankara is two things. People have a problem with Alankara Shastram because it is abstract. It is difficult because it is abstract. And if someone is able to describe such an abstract thing and define it, it requires great expertise.
Yeah.
I feel that Raudram, Anuprasa can bring out Raudram. It can help. But Anuprasa need not... whether it is there or not, It need not help Shrungara.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.